Well guys, welcome to what is my second video of this year. And by the time you're watching this, you'll have seen my Lesmont trip earlier in the year, when it was somewhat easier to get over to France. It's now Tuesday, 2nd of June. We had a bank holiday yesterday, and right now, as of yesterday, getting through to France, you know, justifiably so, I guess, and everyone's got views on all of this COVID lark, and my videos ain't about documenting people's thoughts on that, but the long and short of it is, it's much more difficult to be getting through now to France for the next 3-4 weeks, maybe more, you know. So like all the anglers, I'm following what's going on because I'm hoping to be out at the end of June, and then I've got a rainbow trip in July, so we've just got to play that by ear. For now, I'm popping down to Gates's, Kenny Gates' asylum, that I was at back in about April last year, in the, you know, right in the thick of COVID, and we had an update with Ken on what he was up to and so forth. And I thought, you know what, it's about sort of 13-14 months since I've been down there. We'll catch up with Ken. So I'm popping down there lunchtime today, and that will kickstart this video. And as for, you know, what trip follows this, it remains to be seen. But as I say, by the time you're watching this, I'll have been, so you'll know. But right now, yeah, really not too sure. So let's go and catch up with Ken, see what he's been up to, and yeah, take it from there. Yes. It started. So, Ken, 1st of June 2021.
Yep.
And I'm back down at Asylum to catch up with you, which must be, what, about 12-14 months since I was here last.
Yeah.
When COVID had kicked off a month or two. And although that time's gone quickly, you know, it's not been without its challenges for a lot of people this last, you know, 15 months or so. But since I last done the video, tell us what you've been up to and what's been happening at Asylum.
It's that last video, we just, when you spoke to me about it, we thought we'd just do something, just relieve the boredom. No one was doing nothing, and then we you whacked it on the internet. My phone went insane. I don't know if you remember, I was begging you, Kev, please take it down, get my number off. You went, I'm on the way to France, buddy, there's nothing I can do. I got battered, which, it was good seeing it, but I never realised people would watch anything like that. So so many people all over Britain, and they all decided, let's ring Kenny Gates and chat about bait. So some days, 6, 7, 8, 9 hours on the phone. I picked up some tremendous customers out of it. Some have become good friends, but I also got the usual thing, like proper tire kicker punishers. Anybody had my number, and it was a nightmare, but luckily it's all calmed down. Now it pushed us over the edge with supplies, because one minute no one's fishing, then all of a sudden everyone could go fishing. I spent 5 months in here, 7 days a week, 3 late nights a week, family, daughters, sons, everything. There was eight of us working here at one stage. I think it happened everywhere in the fishing industry, but touch wood, it's all calmed down, leveled out. I've managed to keep hold of most of my customers. Where there was a period where we couldn't take any bookings for 8 weeks for bait or anything. We're a small company, we're not one of the big ones.
What, because you were maxed out with orders?
We were totally maxed out with orders, and it took me a little while to get on top of it, and also try not to lose my existing custom through adding new ones on. So we just stopped taking orders. It was quite a bad position to be in, but a good position. So,
yeah, so you got through the COVID period.
Yeah.
Yeah, and now, so June, you know, you were saying earlier about your French orders are sort of not nearly as prolific right now because people are uncertain about going to France, and certainly not going generally at the moment. So yeah. How have you overcome that then in terms of, you know, satisfying other orders and so forth?
Well, luckily, I mean, our business is down. I think in the bait trade throughout the whole industry, most companies are down 40% plus, because no one's taking bait to France. It's a big earner. Big amounts of bait, Some of the bigger companies are down millions of pounds, but for us, I'm actually glad of the break, which is not good from a business point of view, but at least we're coping with the demand. We've still got the same customers buying bait, but they're all fishing here. They're buying much less volumes, where they'd take 100 kilo or 200 kilo to France for a week or two. They're buying 30, 40 kilos now. So for us, it's good. It gives us time to cope. I've never seen anything like it. I mean, no one's seen anything like this ever in their life, but it, like business point of view, you plan things ahead, and it all goes out the window. A lot of friends of mine have all gone bankrupt. Some are busy as hell. There's no rhyme or reason. So anyone in the building trade, they've been busy as hell. Now the whole world's run out of cement, plaster, everything. There's no plugs laying about, anything. China's backlog, there's wood shortages, and same in the bait industry, where places have been in lockdown, trying to get hold of ingredients is a nightmare.
Okay, so rewinding,
yeah,
to, you know, 14 months ago, and we, yeah, were talking about your bait ranges, ground bait and so forth. Has anything changed? Because I think you've added one or two baits, have you, to that list that was in development last year?
I mean, how we are, we don't operate what most, the modern trend of carp fishing. The modern trend of carp fishing is what's new. I'll get people walk through the door, anything new? Not really, mate. I've got the Marine, which we've used for 30 odd years, the Red Spice we used for 30 years. Take it anywhere, it will just catch them. We're always working on pushing the boundaries in certain things. I mean, we've been probably playing with two new baits for 3 years. New EU regulations, Britain's had to follow. One of them was a cheese amino based product, fantastic, discontinued, new EU rules. We was playing with something else, a very, very exceptional product, discontinued. So we do a lot of rolling, a lot of testing, sending people out, whatever. We know mostly what works, what doesn't, just finding levels, etc. But we've probably spent nearly 3 years developing two baits, trying to be different to what everyone else is doing, and we've been kicked up the guts by the Brexit, new EU regulations. So we sort of try and promote good bait, that we're not looking for what's the next bait this year, what's the next bait that year, what's new. Just come and buy bait. We do five, they work. Our newest one, which has been in the pipeline for years, is the R1, the Rebel, which I think when you come down, we've been playing with it.
You had, and yeah, and it was an old school bait that you'd acquired some ingredients from someone, and you was working on it.
Yeah, a lot of work went into it. Took us a long time to get it right, research. Just try to make, I think, a really high-end fish meal, but just something slightly different to what's out there. So we just done two different LTs, a couple of other bits, massive levels of pre-digested, squid meal. We've got a couple of feeding stimulators, which I don't tell people about. Very, very good products. One comes from Asia. Phenomenal products. We put that in, we added a few bits in, just different from the Marine. The Marine isn't like an HMV type, it's got everything in it. Milk proteins, and then just gone on a different tangent. And it took us a while to get it right. Any decent bait will catch fish, but you want it to outcatch everything else out there. So that R1 is, and on art, I'd say, is the best bait I will ever make. It is the ultimate food source, proper fish meal, how they should be made. No expense spared, and my God, does it whack them.
We'll have a look at that in a moment. Ken, when we was here last year, and we did the film, we were talking about ground bait, and you suggesting it was an overlooked way of fishing by a lot of anglers, myself included.
Yep.
And, you know, I came away from here then with a lot of ground bait, and I used it to good effect last year and already this year. Did that take off, the ground bait? Have people sort of picked up on that? Or is it still very much sort of an underused approach?
The majority of carp fishermen out there, they just want a bag they take out of the freezer and fire it in. That's it. Or stick it on the back of a radio control boat, send it out, or put it on a pole. If they've actually, a lot of them, if they've got to work to do their bait, obviously people are very busy, but if you just put a bit of thought into your bait, there's edges. And we'd all the boys who come in here, a lot of them, once they try that ground bait, it's a massive edge. England, France, everywhere, people go, oh, there's roach in that in the water, they'll eat it. Exactly, get them feeding. You look at the filming on coral reefs and that, if you want to get the big fish in, you've got to start feeding the little ones, like Jack Cousteau, do you remember him?
Yeah, he's 70s, 80s,
get the little
fish. The youngsters won't remember him, us oldens will. Yeah.
Or Steve Irwin, get the little fish feeding, bigger ones come, then the groupers come, then get them feeding, and then the signal goes out, that's when the big sharks come, and then everything disappears. And that's the ethos behind ground bait. When you've got a match man, brilliant match fishermen, they trickle a little bit of ground, just a little bit of cloud, get the fish going, get a signal in the water, then they go in with their maggots. They don't throw a load of maggots in because they sink to the bottom and the fish are just sitting there. Get the cloud in, get the stimulus in. If you've got feeding stimulants, ingredients that the fish want to eat, soluble, get them in the water. The ground bait is phenomenal, but it's just getting your head around it. I won't pre-baiting, just go and pre-bait a spot. They eat the silt, they eat the weed, they strip it because they're looking for all the ground bait goes in the silt. It's fantastic.
Yeah, I remember you saying the same last year. Ken, we'll have a look at some of the bait inside.
Yeah.
As far as people contacting you moving forward, right? So how would you like people that are interested in your bait to be able to contact you?
During the day, we're working hard. It's very difficult to answer the phone. Smothered in paste, gloves on, and we're busy. So all day long, my phone's ringing. People go, oh, I can't get hold of him. I do apologise, but we're trying to work. If you want to ring me after 3 o'clock. I'll answer the phone. We will be doing... We never wanted to get to this stage, but unfortunately, it's grown. The monster has grown. It's getting too much. So what we're doing now, we're doing a little information catalogue. So when you ring up, I'll just send you the catalogue. It's a lot easier than trying to explain it on the phone. You can read
so that's
it.
A printed catalogue as well as an e-catalogue that you can send to people in a PDF. Which is how my industry works
that's
now.
Very
rarely are companies going to the expense of posting hard copies. It's a nice to have,
that's
don't
it.
Get me wrong,
yeah.
But you know, most people now will pick up a PDF.
That's it, we deal with both, we deal with
so
the PDF for
both.
The younger, but there's a lot of old boys out there and people who they want something to look at and read, so
fair
we
point,
just
yeah.
ping the catalogue. That might speed things up here a bit because when I'm in there working, production goes up and you get your bait quicker, but we're not a mass production place, we just roll it all fresh every couple of weeks. The bait doesn't sit in our freezers longer than 2 or 3 weeks, and that's how we like it.
And what about email? Are you working on email in terms of contact yet?
I have got email number. Yeah, people do email me. So, right. But I just tell them with an order, just speak to me, see what you want, run through it, and the easiest format is WhatsApp. WhatsApp me your order.
Yeah.
It's free.
Yeah, okay. So
WhatsApp, email.
So
anything.
I'll put your contact details on again then, should I? Or
no,
should
no,
I?
No, 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 no. No, if people want me, we'll get to you. No, the word of mouth seems to be, it works better. People fish a lake, they see someone catching a lot of fish, you go and see what you're up to, oh, what bait you on, go and see this fella. Most of them don't want to tell you. Because they've got a very good edge, but there's plenty of good baits out there, but we just try to, what we do is...
So for someone watching this video that doesn't know about Asylum, but wants to contact you, what should they do?
Ring
so
us
we're
after
clear.
3 o'clock.
Ring you after 3 o'clock on the mobile number.
On the mobile number.
Right, okay.
We have got a factory number, which is will be coming into play once we get the office side of it sorted, but
or they could WhatsApp you then.
The easiest way is ring me and then just WhatsApp your order. Yeah.
Right, okay, cool. Alright, so we'll have a look at some ingredients inside and catch up inside, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
We've got heat wave here, it's 20 degrees.
I know.
Yeah? Yeah, so Ken, just talk us through the baits again then, the range of baits that you've got.
That's it. right?
Yeah.
So at this end, you've got the Meganat, maple Meganat, which we've totally just changed, revamped. We've added in a few more protein sources, an isolated nut protein, another whey protein, so there's now two in there. It's beautiful. We changed the flavour. Same thing, it's a maple cream type thing, but we just blend it ourselves. It's lovely. Tremendous active bait. It catches easy fishing waters anywhere. Go on a hard water, you'll out catch anyone. It's so active. I'll show you one sec. It's so active.
So that's maple Meganut.
That is that, yeah. 5 days in, as soon as you can get it to start flicking white, it's bang on. It's a little culture in there. It's very active. The hotter it is, the quicker it turns, but Meganut inside, there it is. It is a phenomenal. It's lovely. It smells quite yeasty.
Okay, I can smell it, yeah.
Yeah, it's very, very, very good.
Yeah, okay, so that's the maple Meganut.
Yeah.
Red spice, which I'm familiar with.
Yeah, Receptor red spice again. Yeah. Still doing all the fish everywhere. I mean, that bait there, a fella come in before Christmas fishing up a very well-known lake, got a very big common in it. He'd love to catch it. That bait picks off commons. Look back to the old days when Tim Paisley and that used to write about bait, and he studied it properly. He showed identifying factors, and when you read through the old Nutribaits catalogues and speak to people like Jim, certain things pick up commons. And so we put them in that bait. Excuse me, it's got up my nose, that yeast. Oh. Normally have a white powder in Essex, gets up your nose, doesn't it? But yeah, not here though. Quite often I do it. People are fishing a lake with a big common. There's no one else on that bait. I tell them, I shake their hand, do 10 nights if they're a half decent angler. Do 10 nights, if you haven't caught the big common, come back, I'll give you your money back. And they look at me like I'm on drugs, right? Matey went out, bought the bait, gone off. First trip, big mirror. Second trip, 55 common. He went, how did you know? I said, he's got the stuff in, what commons eat? Another fella, fishing another lake up in Hertfordshire. Sold him 20 kilos, same thing. Shook his hand, I went, come back, if you haven't caught it within 10 nights, I'll give you your money back. He went off from here, hour and a half later, had one of the 40s. Following morning, had the second 40. So it does work. It's
so what is that ingredient?
It's just, nice. If you read Tim Paisley's old books and the old Nutribaits catalogues, there's several ingredients what commons identify to. For some reason, various reasons, that bait there, it's, if you look at the wall, it's done big commons everywhere there. Mark Wootton, he wanted to catch a big common in frying in the Moman. I told him red spice. He'd done a weekend, never caught it. 3 weekends later, he had it. And it works everywhere. If you go through that list.
It's astonishing wall fish.
It stopped writing in October 18. It just got too much to keep up. There's hundreds missing off there. But on that list, there's commons, Averley, my lake. One of my fish in my lake's been caught 13 times, I think, probably more, just on the red spice. It doesn't blow, they just eat it, because it's got liver powder, crustacean meals, and it's different to everything out there. Winter-wise, you can't beat it. It is number one. It will outfish anything.
So, next one. Cream Amino.
Again, going on a different line, the way the baits work, if you pan down a sec, I'll show you. Blend of fish meals, high levels of pre-digested, everything's in there. Whey proteins, caseinates, the lot. Very complicated, 28 ingredients altogether. With
flavors. 28 ingredients?
With the liquids, powders. And then you go to this one, which is the R1, the new one. So we've just gone full on hardcore fish meal. A handful of ingredients, probably 2 handfuls, just designed how an old fish meal should be, but using modern type fish meals, 2 different LTs, high levels of pre-digested, and the squid meal is exceptional.
Okay, so to summarise, Ken, because I'm not sure I caught some of that, right? Yeah. So we've got maple Meganut, red spice,
yeah?
Then we've got the cream amino,
Yeah.
Yeah. There. Then we've got
Receptor Marine.
Receptor Marine.
Yeah.
And then the new bait, which he was researching last year, which is the
R1.
The R1. Right, okay. Yeah. So they're the five baits, and available in what sizes?
We stock them in the freezers and do them to order, slightly bigger, but freezer stock, 14mm, 16mm, 18mm. And then if you want bigger, we can do bigger. We can go up to 24.
And you've got the hard hook baits, pop-ups, ground bait to go with each of them.
That's it. We do hard hook baits and wafters, 12, 14, 16, 18. And pop-ups, we do 12, 14, 16. But we only do 18mm because you need, it's like one of the old boys that go in jaws in a film, they stick up properly. So as a stock item, 12, 14, 16 on the
right,
pop-ups.
Right, got it, yeah, okay. Yeah, Ken, you were saying the point you was going to make. Go on.
Yeah. When you talk about doing these videos, I'm not trying to promote business. I'm just trying to put a bit of information out there so it slows the phone calls down, really. But if you do need to ring me, try and ring me after 3 o'clock, and I'll answer, because everyone rings me in their lunch break or in the breakfast break. You can tell, and I can't.
Yeah, don't stop.
Phone.
Yeah.
People do get infuriated, but we're trying to work. So give us a call. Preferably after 3 o'clock, and I'll answer.
Yep, cool. All right, buddy. Makes sense. Thanks for that, Ken.
No problem. Thank you.
Well, guys, it's one of those bear with me moments. It's Saturday, 26th of June, 21. And I've got to say, well done to all the river anglers that have been catching some magnificent fish. Well done to you guys. It's been great to follow that. It's a few weeks since I was at Gates's Asylum, which kickstarts this video, and right now, tomorrow, Sunday morning, I head off to Feuillette for 1 week, which is a trip we had booked last year, which we had to cancel. There was two trips on Feuillette that we had to cancel, and this is my first time there now in a couple of years, and we managed to get this slot, which just a few of us are making. In fact, there's five of us, and now potentially only four of us that are going. But anyway, it is what it is. So tomorrow morning, set off for Feuillette, 1 week. Then I was due to be back a week and then go to Rainbow for 2 weeks on Kev the Lead's trip in Peg 11. But what with everything going on, didn't make sense to come back for a week, not least of all the quarantine, the expense, the tests and this, that and the other. So my wife, bless her, suggested, with no prompting much, why don't I stay? So I'm going to France for 4 weeks, boys. I've never been to France for 4 weeks. Most I've ever done is two. So my wife reckons I'll turn feral. We'll see. So what I'm doing is, I've got a week on Feuillette. I've then got, on the Sunday, pack up, go to Lesmont, fish from Sunday to Friday, pack up on the Friday, drive down to north of Bordeaux, stay Friday night in a hotel, and then toodle round Bordeaux to Rainbow for 2 o'clock on the Saturday, which is the time now you're allowed on the lake with the the previous anglers having packed up and gone. So that's what I'm doing. I won't labour it now, but I've packed the van, and crikey if I've got some gear. And to think I used to go to Rainbow or anywhere in my wife's RAV. When I got that van, I thought I'd never fill that up. Now, I'm thinking I need a bigger van. But anyway, that's what I'm doing. The weather looks great for next week. And obviously with all the COVID stuff going on, things are somewhat more relaxed in getting to France. Still not ideal, but it is what it is, and I'm getting on with it. So watch this space, follow the journey, guys, and look forward to sharing it with you. Well, I'm proper happy. We caught up with Lou and Dickie, who's with us, and Andy. We've had a draw, it was raining, so I couldn't get the camera out. Andy got number one, so he's picked peg five, as I would have done. I got number two and picked peg one, and the boys have got peg two and three, effectively, but mainly two. And the lake looks bang on. The lake's a lot higher than
I've seen it before, but then I haven't fished it this time of year that I can recall. And yeah, it looks fantastic. Look at this.
It's mild, overcast, and there's a smell of fish in the air. So a familiar swim to me. I've parked here because it's peeing down. Unload as much gear as I can into the up. And yeah, there's my probable hot spots that I'm familiar with. There's no rope running down the middle of the lake now. So there's the out of bounds. There's peg 5. The boys will be over there in peg 2. And yeah, looks mad for it. So anyway, gonna have a cup of tea because I'm gasping, a light bite to eat, and get set up.
Well, it's far from a cup of tea moment. That's a few hours away. It's 2 o'clock, just gone 2, and honestly, the conditions, everyone fishing in France right now must be rubbing their hands together because they are really good this week. Could do with probably a bit more wind, but you know what? I'd rather this than, you know, high pressure and red hot. So yeah, I'm having a cup of tea, light bite to eat, and then yeah, getting on with it. Should have the rods out by about 6 o'clock, and yeah, so excited to kickstart here. The trips to France, you know, didn't get here last year. Let's have a bit of tea. Yeah, didn't get here last year with one thing and another, and but yeah, do love this lake. Oh, there's another fish. They're all over the place. I'll tell you what, Andy, anyone coming out number one would have picked 5. And yeah, he's there on his own. So I think he's going to club them. But anyway, let's get it sorted out. Well, it's 4 o'clock now, Sunday afternoon. It just took a couple of hours to get my gear ready, given that I've done most of the preparation at home, rigs and stuff. So I'm going to go around and check up with Dickie and Lou. First time I met these boys, they're mates of Chris Smith, who couldn't make it. And yeah, well done, Chris. You've got back yesterday from Rainbow. Congratulations on your captures, mate. And everyone else out there, yeah, some great catches. Yeah, so I'm going to go around, catch up with the boys, make sure they're okay. Chris said look after them. It's a bit daunting for them coming out of France and all that. So me and Andy and we take them under our wing, but anyway, we're going to see them. And then I'll get back, cup of tea, get the rods out. Well, get the rods out, cup of tea moment. But you know, it's lovely to be back at Feuillette. It really is a lovely lake. Water's up higher than what I'm used to seeing. And yeah, it just looks mad for it. And yeah, as people will know watching my videos, I'm very familiar with Peg 1. Had some great captures in there. Having said that, you know, this lake's been kind to me, so I won't count my blessings just yet, but yeah, cracking fishery this. That's me over there in Peg 1. Heard some fish in this corner here. There's the out of bounds. Andy over there in Peg 5. And I'm walking up to see the boys. I think that might be the bailiff just turned up. Yeah, so I've come round to see Dickie and Lou. They're here, look. He's a bit camera shy, but they're in 2 and 3, and it does look good. And there was no one on last week. In fact, we don't even know if there was anyone on the week before. We didn't ask, but there was no one on last week, and that might be why we're seeing so many fish in the margins, because they've come in to sort of eat out of the weed and stuff which is in the margin. You know, there's a lot of fish close in compared to what I'm used to seeing. So yeah, interesting.
Anyway, I'll tell you what though, boys, what a great start of the week, knowing there's no one here last week. Yeah,
yep.
And and the conditions are bang on, so no excuses. Yeah, we need to be catching some fish.
We don't have a Mrs. Fault.
Dickie, I'll catch up with you, right? Because can't get a cup of tea, so I'm going back round mine.
Well, are you offering the same at your end?
Yeah, I've always cup of tea at mine, but you do dinner, I'll do the tea. Cup of tea. All right, so I'm going to leave you to it now. If you need any help, don't call me. All right.
That left-hand rod is down in that corner.
over there. There's quite a few fish moving right in that corner. Well, boys, 10 to 6, Sunday. Always a busy day, first day, but boy, is it exciting and it feels mad for it. And do you know what? I might have missed a trick because that left hand margin, those fish were there and I think they're still there, but I've sent the boat down there and what I should have done was probably gone down there and cast out. Well, that's a bit precarious, landing them, getting through the foliage. Those fish were in like 2 foot of water. So I'm just going to go and keep an eye on that. But right now, cheers and... yeah, great to be here and feeling, you know, ultra confident, really am. So yeah, and as I've alluded to on my previous video, my Lesmont one, and you know, messages I've had, guys, you know, anyone who can get out here is taking advantage of the fact that there ain't many anglers coming out and you're catching fish that ain't being fished for at different angles and a lot less pressure, and they're hungry and they've spawned. And even before spawning, you know, good luck to the guys, you know, that have made the effort, because it is a lot of effort and a lot of expense of late, but you know what, it can be worth it. So yeah, cheers everyone, and yeah, exciting week ahead. I tell you, with the amount of times I've been here, you'd think I'd learn, because there ain't many things I'd bang my head on. Look, I've got to put bloody tea towel here, twice I've banged it, I've only been here a few hours. I'm amazed I ain't had a bite on my left hand rod. I've had a couple of liners on it. There's a few fish right in that corner. If I hold this here, I won't probably need to be long. You should see something. I'm going to get these two fish back quickly. I reckon that's about 32 pound, that fish. But I've got to get them back, because there are so many fish out there, it's unbelievable. And there's a common there, really long, which I'm guessing is about really thin, probably about 26 pound. So let's get these back and get them back out. Well, mid-morning now, Monday, and I had three in the night. Small common, probably 10 pound, one about 28 and the other one about 32, but in truth it was quite a night than I was expecting. The boys had one, but they had a 42, so nice fish, and Andy lost one. So yeah, a lot of fish moving, but not so much in the sanctuary. There was more out of the sanctuary, and maybe that's because I ain't had the pressure. They've moved out around the lake, because I had all three fish on my left hand rods, nothing up against the sanctuary. So anyway, just gonna have a regroup now, and yeah, heavy rain in the night, which made it feel even better. Now warm sunshine, and I think we've got a mixture of that all week.
Yeah!
Well, while I was cooking that, midday Monday, I went far off winding in the rods. My writing rods were really quiet all night. It's tore off. I've got what might be a scraper 40 mirror. Beautiful fish. I'm going to finish my roll and get it out. Superb. £39. Fifth fish, midday, Monday. What a beauty. These are lovely fish in here. Such a mixture of strains. Well, happy with that. Well, I'm just winding in now. Go and catch up with the boys. Yeah, there's fish all around, all over the lake. And I think with the lack of pressure, I don't think the fish are in the reserve like they would normally be, which ain't a bad thing for all of us. So it's my fifth fish. I was pleased to get one, that one, £39. Have a wander about for a couple of hours and then come back, regroup and get them out. But great start. Well pleased with that. Well, it's approaching 6 o'clock Monday evening. Wound in, had a few hours break with the boys, having a catch up with them. And right now, rods are back out. I'm going to have an early dinner and try and get a few hours kit. We're due a really bad thunderstorm, Andy was saying. He's a sailor. He sails boats, so he follows the weather. And so anyway, I don't know why I needed to tell you, he's a sailor. Anyway, but so he's over in five. He lost one. The boys, as I say, had a low 40 in the night. You just feel like the big ones are just going to turn up. Just really, really do. But anyway, this is the scene. Monday evening. And tomorrow, if there's the same activity down there as I saw earlier, me and Andy are going to go down there and have a zig out each and have a bit of a social. Because there's a lot of fish on the surface.
If no one's going to be listening tomorrow, our boss...
Look at that. Lovely fish early as a Tuesday morning. Just as I was putting out my other rod, having had a bream.
How's this for a creature? £38. Early as a Tuesday morning. What a beauty. Look at this fish. Absolute cracker. Big scales on it.
What a great fish. Well, guys, what a battle I've had with a common. I had it on for about 50 minutes. I think it's about 46, 47 pound. What a fish. What a fight. It's in the retainer. It's about 5 o'clock now. I need to have a cup of tea. What a battle. It's what we do it for. It's fantastic. Bloody lead didn't come off. That's a nice fish as well. Look at that. Happy days.
Boys have got their light on over there. I think they've had a nice one as well by the look of the activity when I was playing that fish.
£39. Happy days. Well, lunchtime Tuesday, and I had to have a few hours kip. I was whacked, but that turned out to be a great night's fishing. I had six fish, and that common and that mirror. Crikey, they fought hard. Anyway, as they always do, as they seem to do everywhere. Maybe it's me. Maybe my bones are aching now as I'm getting older, because everything seems to fight so hard. But anyway, having a cup of tea. And I'm going to go around, catch up with the boys, see how they got on last night. Andy's moved, which is a good move, into four, given the amount of fish that are up in that top right-hand corner. I'll have some lunch with the lads, nice lunch. They don't know I'm having lunch with them yet. It'll be a nice surprise, see what they've got. Anyway, cup of tea. Spend a few hours catching up with the lads, then get back for tea time. And get the rods back out for early evening. Yeah, so we're just walking up now to see Dickie and Lou, who are in two. So their torch was on in the night, so hopefully they've had some fish. Then I'll catch up with Andy. It's overcast, it's really mild, overcast. This is just like a great week to be in France. Yeah, anyone who's out here, you know, compared with red hot and high pressure, conditions really are good. See me, I go in the lake. Watch out, yeah?
Such a pervert around here with a camera.
I'll tell you what, that ain't a bad backside. I've seen worse.
Oh, I thought you had a
coat. It's
a coat.
Oh, no,
we thought that was your smoking jacket.
It's Duncan Goodhue.
We thought that was your smoking jacket, mate.
Let's not fucking start, eh? Boy. I thought you was an extra out of the bleeding munchkins.
Do you see me in there?
Of course, I thought I joined.
It's like Cassie, 1986, all over again. Your torch was on last night then, Dickie?
Yeah,
What's going on?
We had a 48.13.
Oh, did you? Yeah. Lovely. Yeah.
You had, you're cooking a barbie, I've heard, though. £49.
48, mine.
Oh, shrunk.
Yeah, so 13 ounces smaller.
It's gone down a pound as soon as you mentioned the barbie.
Yeah, that's a nice result. Well done. And do you have any others?
Yeah, we've had £41 common, and I think I might be on the top smallest rod. We estimated it about £18.
Common. Yeah, lovely. Yeah,
I bet he's still, Kev.
I can't look at that. Yeah. I do want to look, really.
Come on.
And Ange, you've moved then into four.
Yeah.
And why?
Why? Because I can still fish five's water, but there's a stack of fish down in that right-hand corner to the right.
There is, isn't there?
Too many to ignore.
Are they still showing down there?
Yeah.
Are they, on the surface?
Yeah, no. Right. No, not like yesterday, but...
Today. Yeah.
On the bottom.
Yeah, in this left-hand corner. Yeah. Right, yeah.
Today.
Yeah. I've never seen the fish be on the surface so much here as this week so far.
It's pretty humid, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, it's pretty...
Yeah.
I mean, last night was great, wasn't it? Thunderstorms all around. I mean, you just felt that it was going to happen, didn't it?
I'll tell you what, though, it's skirted either past the side of us and left us.
Yeah, I know.
I'd have been quite happy having it.
Yeah,
because it always kicks off here after a thunderstorm.
Last night, south of England, God, they had some bad ones.
What about that?
Have they?
Yeah, my wife, my house, they lost all the power for 4 hours.
Yeah, so you had a nice night's fishing then.
Nice quiet night.
Yeah, happy
not
days.
Not so bad this morning.
Right. So what, it kicked off this morning as
so
opposed
to... 4 o'clock.
Right.
4 o'clock to about 10 o'clock.
Right. Yeah, nice one.
A little later.
Yeah, well, I off. Think we should celebrate with a little bit of lunch because I've got nothing around there. It's all frozen, right? Yeah, and I was going to do the barbecue, but yours is 13 ounces bigger than mine. So was you're it? Doing the barbie so far. Could all change. But yeah, let's all have a nice lunch together. And then, look, Duncan, look. He's Duncan Goodson.
He's going
into... you're too young, remember
him. I know, he is. I thought it was Casper.
I'm cooking illegal chicken. You can't eat that, mate.
Why is it illegal?
Because he has to have it specially. Like,
I'll come round.
Tell you what, got a lovely colour, ain't you?
I tell you what, I'm a little bit worried about you because you're a little bit red. You're like, you know, I'm worried. Like, yeah. Like a boat.
Well, the boys are properly looking after me. Come round here for lunch. Tuesday afternoon, they've caught some cracking fish, and he's had a nice one, hasn't he? He's now moved, all to play for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at that, now. It's a walking cholesterol unit.
Andy caught free lunch, not Andy, Kev. Caught free lunch. Same as yesterday.
Pal, I don't know if this is true, if anyone else has had this, he's invited us round to his bib, he's going to look after us, but we're not sure if that's bullshit or not, excuse the language.
I've never been fishing with mine. I'll tell you what, you talk about having a pint watching the football
don't
tonight.
Don't tell that woman, because I eat better yeah, I'll do it at
you
home.
Better get, you better get him a pint of blood.
You need to drink a pint of tannins solution, I think. Don't
know. Well, we're all chatting away, having a nice lunch, strategising for the game this evening.
Yes. That's the first and only time you heard Kevin talking about football.
And Lou's got a bite in the heat of the day, mid-afternoon. Bang on.
And to his friends, known as Luigi.
Luigi, right, yeah. All looking with that cloud and that, it's looking a bit dark through this viewfinder. Need to have a bit of light. It's doing dark again.
No, they can't do that.
Let's
hope it only grass carp.
It's a grass carp, is it?
Yeah.
Have you got your line?
No.
It's grassy, yeah. They were big. I'm grabbing that. Boy, you can put it back on the rest, though, wouldn't you?
Lou, is there anything you want Dickie to do? Half hour later.
Get some time?
No, that's never happening. He ain't ready yet, mate.
Here it goes again.
You might have to edit this.
Well, he looked at 2 o'clock this afternoon. What was the football result then, England, Germany?
We missed it. Yeah, we're still playing this grass carp.
Yeah.
No, mate. If you walked up the bank, I'd do it in a couple of seconds.
Go on,
Ed. Come walk up then, I'll do it. Let's hope the old leg don't scare him off, though.
Hold on, I better put a neutral density filter on. Screen's just gone white. I've got a white out.
That will scare him off.
That's a nice grass, that. Nice one.
I fucking told you what they're about.
He's in the
fucking unbelievable, them fish.
He's
It's gone.
The thing jumped straight out. Oh, he's playing it again.
I'll tell you what, you get your money's worth.
Dickie, looking at that line angle, braid, going down, I reckon you could lop his head off with that braid, drop it another couple of inches. Hey, Dickie. Oh, sorry, that's not Dickie. Dickie.
Well, he's easy, 30. There you go.
Not far from the one, about the size I am.
PB grass.
£36.
Too complex.
So this is your rig.
Single bottom bait.
Quite a long hair.
Longish hair.
Yeah, and you've got a little mesh just boiled crumb to protect your hook.
Yep.
Yeah.
Just to keep it clean on the
good
way shout. Down.
Yeah, nice one.
Just and a blitzed drop-off up lead system.
What's that, fluorocarbon? No, what's that, braided hook link?
Yeah, braided hook link. Fluoro leader.
Yeah. Cool. All right, so I'll catch you boys in a little while.
Yep.
Yeah? See you in a little
look
while.
Look forward to it.
Do you know what? my torch's gone, right? So the battery's knackered. Not sure. Yeah, I'm trying to work it out. If I can't get it working, I'll have him come and stand in me swim all night. Yeah, so I'm coming back to swim now, 3 o'clock Tuesday afternoon. Had nice lunch and banter with the boys. Now I'm just going to re-tackle, get everything ready, go back, have some dinner, watch the football with the guys. Not that I'm right into the football, but it's England and stuff. Have a bit of a social, get back to swim for 8 o'clock, and that'll give me an hour or so to get the rods out. That's the plan. Well, it's just gone 8 o'clock now, Tuesday evening. I went round with the boys, had dinner for the first half, 0-0. Come back, got the rods out, and while I'm doing it, the boys are cheering, and 1-0 followed by 2-0. So well done, England. Great result. Right now, all four rods are out. I've repositioned one rod, and I've put a different one of my rods, which is normally a good rod in this swim, picking up a lot of crap off the bottom. So I've put a pop-up on that rod now, whereas the other rods have all been the bottom baits till now. So yeah, right now, due to some heavy rain, this is the scene. Tuesday evening. Andy's moved up into 4, which is a good call. A lot of fish up there. Well, guys, it's Wednesday morning, and what a challenging that night that was. The rain has been relentless, like you rarely see. It's been, you know, heavy rain all night. I had a fish in the night I had to put straight back through frustration, probably about 42 pounds, maybe 44 pounds, beautiful mirror. It was just too precarious down there. The way I'm having to get down to the swim and everything else and get up with it, it was too much. Put it back, tried to get it on the GoPro, I don't know if that worked, and I've got 2 fish I have had in quick succession this morning. I've had to put them in the retainers, have a cup of tea and dry out, because getting up and down here is not easy. Anyway, that apart, I'm having a cup of tea. So to have had 3 fish in the night, I'm pleased with that, and 3, you know, great sized fish by the looks of things. But crikey, it's been challenging, let me tell you. Don't know how the boys have got on. There's another one.
Well, guys, Wednesday morning, and I had three fish in the night, but it was all too much to get them on the camera. It was too wet, and oh, it's murder. And I didn't even weigh them. I guess a couple of them were mid 30, one a low 40. So I couldn't get the rods out again after that. It was just too much getting up and down that slope with the boat as well. It was just too dangerous. So I managed to have a few hours, well, a good few hours kit, which was much needed. And yeah, so I think I got one of the fish on the GoPro underwater, tried to capture it, but that was the extent of it. But anyway, yeah, just regrouping. That rain was relentless, unbelievable. And it's set to sort of stop now, which it has. Just need to regroup. Well, we've got a bit of sun now, much needed, drying stuff out. It's lunchtime, Wednesday, and yeah, I'm gonna have me lunch, wind in, go and see the boys, and then regroup, tea time. Bringing a little treat round for the boys, having had a lovely dinner with them last night. Watched the football, see how they got on. They was up late, so I guess they had a few beers. Did you have a few more beers than you was expecting last night?
It was a nice night's sleep.
Yeah, didn't get up till late then.
No.
Yeah, good.
No fish to get us up either.
Yeah, it was a great night for football fans, wasn't it?
Super.
Yeah, yeah, good stuff. How are you getting
and
on?
Go to Rome from here.
Can you? You can't even go to quarantine, they just said on the radio. Nah,
if you're going from England, we're not in England.
Oh, of course not. So you're going to Rome, are you?
No.
Oh. Okay, so how are you getting on?
Not a great night. No bites, moving things about today.
Right, I know.
Changing our style, we're going to start filling in rather than fishing for a bite and building up.
Yeah, I see you putting the boat out. Any further, you'll be in Itang 5.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, I did some big ones over there.
Yeah, you come and catch my fish. Show me your rig. What you got on there?
Oh, this, we had this one on last night. A little bit of foam in there just to balance it.
Right, yeah.
Sitting nice like that.
Yes, yeah, so having a little regroup. Thanks for the dinner last night and the wine. That was most enjoyable. Right. I've brought round a little present for the three
breakfast.
Of us. Cup of tea and a doodah. Yeah?
The ones you couldn't eat yesterday.
Yeah. So this is the scene from Peg 2.
As you can see, we had a big storm.
Wednesday lunchtime. Oh, didn't that rain come down?
The whole swim, that.
Didn't it come down? Oh, it's nice to have a... When that cleared an hour or so ago, it was lovely. Yeah. That was relentless all night, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Non-stop.
Diggy.
Yeah, mate.
Oh, it's all right.
Thanks for dinner last night, that was most enjoyable. And while we're on the subject, I did capture this on my phone, but this is a great idea. Such a good idea, I'll make it mine when I get home. This is a foil insulation loft stuff, doodah, to keep their cool boxes cool, and it is really working well. So they're like, it's a blanket that they're wrapping it around, and you know, what's this called, this stuff? SFF Super or something. Anyway, sort of insulation, but it and half working well. Really is working a treat. Anyway, have some, have a snack with the boys. I'll go around and see Andy. He's moved down into Peg 4. Those fish for Andy, they're right in that corner.
Yeah.
Yeah, he can't really see them from where he is, but they are like, yeah.
I haven't seen much around this morning.
10 yards off that corner.
Yeah. One's just gone again in the sanctuary.
Tell you what though, guys, conditions are bang on, aren't they?
How'd you get on our side?
I had three.
All right, any size?
Yeah, 140. I didn't weigh them because it was too wet.
It ran over 48. You had to do the barbecue. Yeah,
no,
Put that on the screen.
Yeah, because right now your 49 is on the money, isn't
it? You're 49, mate. I was 47.
You've changed it.
Same as you.
Yeah, no, I had three. I didn't get the... I've got one on the GoPro and stuff. I'm not sure how the footage come out. It's too wet to get the camera out. This condensates straight away. In fact, I've ordered a new camera today because this is playing up from a rainbow trip.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, in case this goes wrong.
I won't get no more footage on for sale?
Yeah, no, you will. Oh, you will, Duncan.
Duncan.
Well, it's about 4:30 now, Wednesday afternoon. Had a kip this afternoon, which I needed. Just had a bath in the water, in the lake, had a shave. I was starting to look like Robinson Crusoe.
In fact, my wife shaves more than me. Anyway, just about to get the rods out and have an early dinner. And I was just talking to Si from Birmingham, who's on Riviera, and he was saying he was catching a lot of mails. And I've said the same here. There's been a lot of mailfish caught, and it's like the big ones having spawned are sort of, you know, holding back a bit. It's almost like, well, I've, confidence-wise, I've got to tell myself that the big ones are going to start eating. We'll see, because I've had 14 fish now, and ordinarily in that number, you would have expected, you know, at least a couple of bigger ones than I've had. You know, that's fishing, don't get me wrong, and I'm happy to have caught some lovely fish, but you just sense the big ones have got a switch on. And you know, it's an interesting call with Si. Anyway, gonna get them out now and enjoy myself. That's the main thing. Well, 6:15 now, Wednesday. Rods are rebaited. Feeling really confident. There's some blue in the screen. Something's gone wrong with the camera. I've got a new camera coming for halfway through this trip, so just bear with me, guys, when you see this sort of blue turquoisey tint. Not a lot I can do about that. Oh, I think they've got one over there, the boys. That's Andy over there in 4, he's moved up, still fishing a part of 5's water. He had a sturgeon early hours of the morning in that rain. I think he said 90 pound. Yeah, it's a little dumpy mirror, not big. Crikey, it's an unusual fish. Why this is fault. There he is. Oh. Whoa. What an unusual way that fault. Look at him. Little nutcase. Yeah. First fish Wednesday evening. Mid 20. Guess it. 16th fish. And he's only been out there half hour. Really weird bite, this. There we go. Look at that little peewee. Well chuffed. Fish. No jaw in the water. Off you go. Do you know what? Catching a lot of males, these females have got to wake up. There's some big fish to be had. And right now, yeah, the proportion of males I've had like that is high.
Well, that was a bit frustrating. About 9 o'clock, just settled down. Had my dinner, listened to the radio, cup of tea. Right hand rod with my little pop up rig. Fish has got away with it. Bang round, bump, lead gone. Couple of minutes after that, had a take, playing it, hook pulled. First fish I've lost that I've actually hooked. So, bloody gutted. Anyway, regrouped, got them out, and just gonna have a cup of tea, calm my nerves.
Well, after a lot of unusual activity, Wednesday evening. About 11 o'clock, had this 35 pound, much needed, because I was having some funny occurrences out there. This was taken on the pop-up, the little specials that Ryan did at UB. So thanks, Roy, and your little rig. There's the other side briefly, 35 pound, happy days. For that. was my sixth fish, five on right rod, of which I put back a few that were males, sort of 20 pound. Even upper doubles. I think I had the 130, mid 30. So yeah, I think these big females, for whatever reason, don't seem to be biting right now, or I ain't on them. One or the other. Well, it's midday and the sun is shining, which is lovely because we can start drying everything out. I'm having a cup of tea, going round, having lunch with the boys. They don't know we're having lunch. I think I'm inviting myself. We might be having a barbecue today, depends what mood they're in, because they've caught the biggest fish. So, and they've had a good night's fishing. I don't know what they've caught, so I look forward to catching up with them. But I'm just having a cup of tea, just span round. On the subject of boats, which I covered on the Lesmont video, I've got my RT4 here, and like Rowan, he says a lot of the problems you have is user error, and I can relate to that. But simple things, look, I've just took the tray out of the battery compartment just to let some air get to it, yeah, so that the condensation don't build up and this, you know, this sort of thing, you know. And anyway, but that apart, you can see I'm drying everything out. Two rods are in with those two fish this morning. I'll wind those two in shortly. And then, go around and just chill out for a little bit. But you can see I'm just having a regroup now because everything got dirty and wet the last few days. But you know what, it's nice to have them fish. So I think I had seven in the night. So I've had about 20,
think 22 fish now, 23 fish, something like that. So yeah, but you know what, those big ones are out there, and yeah, got 3 nights to make it happen. Might be the boys have had a big one, I don't know. And Andy's had a fish as well, and a grassy, so we'll catch up with Andy as well. Looks like you had a hectic night, you guys.
Oh my god. Kev's here, food's on.
Oh, lovely. That's cheers, why boys. You're here. Go on, what happened?
What didn't happen? Hectic night, yeah. No sleep at all. Really slept since 10 o'clock yesterday morning.
We'd rather that though than no fish.
Yeah.
So, yeah?
So you had a busy night.
Yeah, we both did.
66.5.
No.
Yeah.
Wow, at least one of the big ones has finally come out then. I was saying on the video, the big females are eluding us. Oh, that'll be one of the big ones then. What, mirror or common?
Common.
Yeah. Oh, I need to see a picture of that.
Saddle on her.
Yeah.
Makes a change.
Yeah.
She has some shoulders, I tell you.
Yeah. That's where, yeah, I might have had that fish a couple of years ago.
On her shoulders.
Yeah, yeah, I think I know the fish. You need to show me a picture. Oh, well done. Cracking. You're definitely doing the barbecue.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Well, and what else you have?
Oh, I think we've had
everything. 2 bream.
Yeah.
3 bream.
Sturge.
Yeah.
3 bream.
Yeah, sturge. A couple of we've three grass.
There we go.
That's the smallest took off.
Oh, look, he's on it.
With
3 bream,
a sturge, 2 stockies.
That's the swan.
Oh, no, look, it's his wing.
The thing is, that's why he keeps coming up with Dickie. He thinks it's his mate. Same colour, isn't it?
It don't help.
Yeah, so what carp did you catch in? She had the 66.
66 was the biggest. We had 430s, 140, 2 stockies below 20.
Brilliant. And where was you getting them from?
2 rods. This rod here, straight out. Well, I think it's sort of the middle of the tall tree line.
Yeah.
And from where he is, sort of straight out just towards the pylon.
Yeah, so the fish are widespread then.
Range, yeah. But nothing on any of the other rods.
Really?
Them ones ain't that far away.
Yeah.
Oh, we had one out of here. Yeah.
Yeah, brilliant stuff. Yeah, no well rhyme done. Or yeah, reason. Let's have a look at a picture of the common.
Just.
Yeah, I had that fish a couple of years ago. Superb creature. Well done. And you're fishing one for one, so you're sharing the rods.
Yeah.
So
team effort.
Team effort. Yeah, great team effort. Well done, boys. Yeah, it's a cracking fish that. Yeah. I had it from peg one.
Yeah.
Yeah, well done. Yeah, superb. No wonder we're proper celebrating that with some food now, aren't we? Ain't we, eh? Because I thought I'll only come round. I thought I won't take like advantage and stuff, but now you've had a 66, we can't not celebrate that. Can we? It'd be rude not to. So I'll have everything that's going. Do you know what? That swan thinks you're its mate. Yeah? His long lost mate. Yeah?
I don't understand what you're saying.
I'll tell you what, why don't you wear black or something? Might do you more favours.
Kev?
Yeah? Dickie, I've brought back your chopper. You can borrow it. But I'll tell you what, that is brilliant. That is absolutely brilliant. Kev, guys, I'll demonstrate that, right?
Coming from you.
In fact, why don't you demonstrate it? And I know it's your idea, but by the time I edit the video, it'll be another brilliant idea of mine.
I'm doing lunch at the moment.
Because an ice crusher that Arjun brought to Rainbow about 5-6 years ago turned out to be a bestseller for a certain company. I reckon we could get a carpy version of that. Yeah?
Bloody brilliant.
I'll
have it with
Kev. So that's another thing. There's a tradition on here. Now that they've just discovered that's your PB, we really, really got to push them. You've got to get out of the supermarket and really push the boat out, boys. I wish it was me doing the barbecue, but we did say biggest fish.
Kev, the only problem is, in my religion, I only eat pork.
Well, we can deal with that.
We've not heard what you had, though, because you had quite a lot of fish.
Yeah, so I had 7 fish, but 140, a few 30s and some 20s.
Right. Okay.
Yeah? But I like you up all night, but I'd rather it that way than sleeping all night.
How's Andy getting on?
No, Andy's slow for Andy. I'm not sure what's going on. Yeah, we need to catch up with him. I'll put round there later on. Andy's over there.
Yeah,
but interesting that you're getting nothing on your right hand rods, and I'm getting them like quite widespread.
Yeah. And you're not that far from us, really.
Yeah, but either way.
I've seen your boat edging up this way.
Yeah, it will be tonight. Yeah, worry about that. Yeah, I'll put it in stealth mode. Yeah, I've got black LEDs.
I'll tell you what.
Yeah, you can't see them.
That glow orange reflect off of him, don't matter what weather's like, how dark it is.
Just leave it there, Kev, someone will pick it up for you.
Kevin Ellis just come round and he's just come straight from a festival. Just have a look. Have a look where he was sitting. Maybe he was sitting there and then he relocated just behind him and he was sitting there.
Well, that was an amazing result for the boys at Common. £66, fantastic, and what a creature that is. And yeah, they had a great night's fishing. And we said last night it was going to kick off, and it did. So yeah, Handy. Yeah, I think he had a carp and a sturgeon and a grass. He's not quite getting on them. Although it does look like the fish are down there, but anyway, that's fishing. Right now, I'm going back to the swim. Gonna have a kip, could do with a few hours kip. Then get all my rods re-tackled, get myself sorted, go back round to the boys for dinner, and then get back later and get the rods out probably around 8 o'clock, something like that. But for me, it's certainly been that nighttime bite, and that was a hectic night's fishing for us. And see if we can repeat it. It was nice to see one of them big ones. Yeah, serious fish that. Yeah, well done, guys.
So, to be fair, look at that. That is good.
Randomizer.
Yeah. That's like 15 quid off Amazon.
I know.
Yeah, brilliant.
Can you afford it, Kev?
Well, I've ordered a couple, so I'll take that one, yeah. Right, for the rest of my holiday, yeah. And then I'll send you a new one when they turn up.
Yeah, fine, Bobby.
Yeah, that's cool. A good idea, that. I like that idea. And by the time I've edited this...
I trust anyone from Essex.
Yeah. Hey, do you know what? I've got an idea. Where is he? Is he asleep?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll let him wake up first. Yeah, so what are you knocking up there, then, Diggy?
It's my cake mix.
Oh, nice,
that's
yeah.
As far as I'm prepared to go.
Oh, yeah, that looks good. So what's in it?
Can't tell you that.
Well, I'll edit it out. What's in it?
That is a family recipe. And I call it my cake mix because you have to knock it up like a cake.
Yeah, like it. Yeah.
You have to get in there.
So for people watching this that are into ground bait and stuff, and I'm into ground bait, what have you actually got in there? And I'll leave it out, any secret ingredients.
No way am I ever going to do it. If you had them down the curry house on about 15 pints, and after about 8 I'm on my back, I might be able to divulge that information.
All right, OK, we'll wait then. Yeah, I'll tell you what, we'll wait for the barbecue tomorrow.
Yeah,
yeah? Then we can get...
Yeah.
Did he go shopping?
Yeah, but not for the barbecue, no.
Right, so he was shopping tomorrow for the barbecue?
Yeah. We've got to go out for the PCR test. And go.
Oh, of course you are,
so
yes.
So we're nipping there then.
Yeah, that'd be days. So you're regrouping for tonight. What a great session you had last night, you boys.
Yeah.
Hey, bang on.
It's all about work, isn't it?
You're on it, though. You're on it now, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're proper on it, I can tell you, boys. You know, a night like that, just what you need, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, well done. Yeah, brilliant.
If we can get that little big chap out, who knows? Do you know what I mean?
I'll tell you.
Once they get away for that cake mix, they'll be on it like a bomb.
Oh.
I'll be surprised if you catch anything, Kev, because now it's been in the 2 nights now.
There is
fresh,
that.
It's fresh.
I might have to move in with you boys. Yeah, nice one. Lou, I know you just got up, right? I can see that. I've got an idea for tomorrow. Right, you're having your jab tomorrow, aren't you? Right? And we're having the barbecue tomorrow to celebrate the fish, right? I'm wondering whether that barbecue, we should turn it into a white party.
Look at that.
It's Thursday night.
Dickie White, man. Here with Kevin Ellis. Look at the state of that. Before he's done to her griddle.
Chicken sandwich.
Mrs. Ellis, I'd just like to say you are right. He's gone feral.
That's a game changer. What a sandwich. Holt's Butchers. Yeah, Holt's Butchers Chicken Kiev.
With mayo.
With mayo and tomato.
Cooked in the a knife.
Knife and fork with that. Actually, I'll cut off little bits here.
I will stop recording because Kev's going to open his teeth in a minute and that will cause a bit of a glare, so watch it. Yeah. So hang on.
Almost as white as your legs, Dickie.
So, Ro, we've got your V4 here with the boys, and the point we was making on the group is that none of us know just how much to span out, because you can make that look like a cliff face almost, or a steady slope. So how much do you do that? That's the question. Look, you know, is that a hum? With, you know. So in summary, how far do you know to pan out? I think that's what I'm trying to say. Well, look, they fish. Well, Thursday evening now, about 9 o'clock. Rods are back out. Had a lovely day, not least of all celebrating the boys' 66 common and the white party tomorrow. Look forward to that. But right now, anticipation of the night ahead. Well, it's 10:30 Thursday, and there are fish rolling on my right 2 rods. So I'm feeling mega confident. Looking at them through the bins. Yeah, that's probably the most they've showed since I've been here on those particular spots. I need a kip, look at me. I hope I'm not gonna get it tonight. We'll see. 41 pound. Not long after I said fish will roll. I've had this fish
It's put up one hell of a fight. It's got bulging eyes and an helmet here. You can see, I've seen that in koi, so I'm not going to get it out and photograph it. I'm going to put it straight back. I'm guessing it to be about £45. But yeah, got to do right by this fish, and it don't look in the best of health, unfortunately. So yeah, let's slip her back and do without the stress of let's turn it off. Yeah, do without the stress of getting her out. Look at them eyes. Yeah, let's get her back. Well, guys, Thursday morning. No, Friday morning, and I had three fish in the night, two 40s and a 30, and I had a 20, that was it, I had four fish, and I don't know if I captured it this morning, but I had a bite about 9 o'clock, and I had my glasses on, and I'm running down to the rod, and I've picked up the rod, and it's pulled me in. I can only think it was a sturgeon. It was like hooking a tarpon. It tore off, and I didn't have a fish with backwind. And I've been used to, like, you know, pulling into the fish, you know, leisurely, undoing the backwind, playing the carp, right? That thing, if it come out on the glasses, I kid you not, it pulled me in. And by the time I managed to undo the backwind, fortunately the hook come out, because I'd have still been playing that bloody thing. But anyway, and Andy I think's now had three sturgeon, so yeah, if anyone who wanted to target big sturgeon, this is probably one of the best lakes in France. But anyway, right now having a cup of tea, chilling out, sorting out some tackle. The boys are going off to have their COVID test lunchtime, then getting some food for the barbie, and then I'm going around there this afternoon, dressed accordingly for what I can only describe as a white party. So I'm looking forward to that, and then getting them out this evening. It really is a nighttime bite. Been winding in, chilling out during the day, and it suits me. Yeah, as I say, not least, I managed to have a few hours kip last night, which was much needed as well. Yeah, so this is the scene, lunchtime Friday. I've got one rod out. Wind that in shortly, go and see the boys. So we're here now, Friday afternoon, for the white party. Andy's going back to get dressed because he ain't in white. The rest of us all in white, look.
Ain't got white.
In celebration of their fish. They've been out, had your COVID test, haven't you?
Yeah.
Been to the supermarket, got some drink and everything else, and yeah, we're going to have a few hours fun. But the weather looks bang on for tonight and tomorrow, so the cards are on for another biggie, and the pressure's on there. But for now, we're chilling out. Don't get better than this, does it?
No.
Yeah? So we'll have a drink.
No worries.
And,
nothing to do.
Yeah, it's all great fun. We're running out of things to say now. These your specialty, are they?
Yeah.
Lakeside chips.
Yep.
Oh, Eric does these. Cooks them three times. They're called
triple cook.
Yeah, they're called trois chips. Yeah, he cooks them three times, does a great chip. Yeah, cheers boys. Went for Andy and all, we toast him.
Cheers.
Yeah, glass of Asti. Happy days. Well done on the fish, guys.
That's not that bad.
No.
Oh, that's bang on, that is. Got the music. Only thing we're missing, shame I didn't come down the town with you, book some birds back. Do you want me to go down there now?
Kev, hard at work. What do you reckon, Kev?
Do you know what? The lovely, enjoying the white party. Celebrating their 60. Superb. But tonight, it's going to kick off. Biggin's going to be out again.
Yeah?
Yeah.
For sure?
For sure. I'm telling you. Mark my words, Biggin's out tonight.
You heard it here first.
Yeah.
Well, guys, it's about 7:30 Friday. What a cracking white party that turned out to be. I'm wiped out now.
I've got to go and lay on the bed chair for a couple of hours. When you get the rods out, I can feel biggins. I can feel biggins on the cards. Well, guys, I've come back, had a couple of cups of tea. I know that I've had a glass of wine or two, but I'm alright. A bit light-headed. There are fish all over this lake right now. None more so than in my swim. It remains to be seen just how big they are, because there's been a lot of males, 20, 30 pounders out there. And like I said on the Lesmont video, you know, you never look a gift horse in the mouth. A 30 pound carp's a big carp, but you're here for the target fish. Like I've said before, if you're on a lake and the biggest fish, I don't know, in the lake's 26 pounds, you want to catch it. Well, the biggest fish in here now is probably up to 70, you want to catch it. But right now, as I'm talking to you, if I pan round, you can see that there's just the remnants of a fish moving there in front of the yellow boy. They're on that line there, which is about 140 yards away. I don't know, 150 yards, something like that. But this is the scene now, Friday evening, and we're hoping to hear a cheer, because we've said whoever gets a big one is going to give an almighty cheer tonight. Oh, look, there's one. At 8:30 Friday evening, traps are set, and I just know I'm going to catch. So whether I can bag a big one. But either way, yeah, nice to be catching fish. Guys, I'm not I'm not weighing them unless they're probably 40 pound plus, because there's a lot of effort getting up and down there. So that fish was probably 32-34 pound. I'm happy just to put them back, less aggro on the fish, but less aggro on me and all. It's been trying, let me tell you. Anyway, let's get that rod back out again. It's about 9:30 Friday. Just putting this back now, low 30 common, second fish of this evening. Well, there's a lovely chunky mirror there. I would guess, again, about 32 pound. Big head on it. But I'm going to put him straight back, try and get it on the underwater footage with a GoPro, but yeah, nice fish. Well, I've got a koi here. I thought it was a sturgeon. Look at that. It's like a shusui mixture of things. In koi terms, that's probably the equivalent of a Great Dane cross with a Chihuahua. But anyway, it's novelty value, probably about 12 pound. Get him going back. Oh, ho, ho, it's magic. Saturday morning. First light. What a hectic night I had. As did the boys. Torches on all over the place. And this has just gone off. Never been away, Hake. Never seen a day break. Leaning on my pillow in the morning light. Oh.
love a sunny day. Dream of far away, dreaming on my pillow in the morning. Never been away, hey, never seen a day break. Leaning on my pillow in the morning.
Well, I think it's about, what is it, 6:30 Saturday morning, and what a hectic night that was. Can't quite recall what I had. I think I had 8 fish, and that was the biggest. So, yeah, rebaited, took that video, I'm going to have a lay down now. I was going to have a cup of tea, but it'll keep me up. I'll try and get some kip. Yeah. This is the scene, Saturday morning. We all looked like we had plenty of fish. £43. The hardest fighting 40 I've ever had. And I think I've had this fish at 30. £43, I'm gonna check. I've got a feeling with the shape and the immense fight, I've had it before when it's 30 odd. £43. What a creature. Well, it's 8:30, Saturday evening. Boys are getting ready to watch the football. I'm getting ready to get my head down, catch up on some sleep. It looks mad for it again. It's been a great week. It's not over yet. Time for a big one. Fish moving in the normal spots. So a night under the stars. So reminds me of Anal, summer of 76, me and Pete, in the absence of having any proper shelter, fishing moving all over the place. Well, it's about 11:30, and there's a first for me. I had 3 bites at the same time. As I'm playing one, the other rod went off. As I'm trying to get that one in to get the second rod, I hook pulled, landed the second one, and as I'm playing that, the third one's gone off. So I managed to get 2 fish in, both mid 30 mirrors. Ain't got time to get them out. Gonna quickly get them in the nets where they're currently lying, get them back, get the rods out there. I think a big one could be on the cards.
It was all muddy. But there's a lovely fish. Ordinarily I'd love to get it out. That's probably an upper 30. But I'm on my own. It's just too precarious for what's going on. So that's one. The other one's here. This is a shorter fish, but much better. So let's get these back and get the rods back out. Thank you, fish. Love to have a picture with you, but needs must. Look at these, they're beauties. So much turmoil here, the water's gone all murky. Here we are, come out here. Oh, you're fat. I can feel you. There you go. Two beautiful fish, look at them. Thank you, fish. I'd normally love my picture taken with you, but I think there's a big one out there with my name on. Come on out. Normally be loving to hold you. Look at you. Look at you. You are a beauty. Come out. Come out. Look at that. What a lovely carp. Look at him. He's a beauty. Go on, babe. It's fish number 5 or 6, I can't remember now. I'm going to say that fish is up a 30. So, I ain't got the energy to get it out. I'm wiped out, all the rods are in now. What a lovely fish. And I do love getting pictures of them, but Yeah. Needs must. I had no sleep last night. No sleep tonight. It's got the better of me. Go on, baby. Off you go. Well, guys, it's just gone 9 o'clock Sunday morning. I had a lay in. I couldn't put the rods out again, and I'm quite tenacious in getting rods out. But it all got the better of me. I've had about 4 hours kip, which I needed. But I had seven or eight fish, I think, in the night. A few 30s. The big one eluded me. All the rods are in now. It's peeing down. I slept in the little shed, but. You know what it's like packing up when it's torrential rain, but the conditions look good for the boys. So yeah, good luck to you guys, Andy and your mates. Nice to meet you boys, and yeah, let's hope the big ones come your way. They certainly eluded me, but had a great time. Now cup of tea, get everything packed. I largely packed yesterday, put away the Oz tent and one thing and another, and now just bolt over to Lesmont. So yeah, next time the camera's out, I'll probably be, well, I'll thank the lake and then get my way to Lesmont. And on that note, yeah, thanks again, Swim. Been kind to me. Look at that fish boshing the out of bounds. Yeah, it really did switch on last night. And I think those females were just holding back from feeding post-spawning. That's what I'm suggesting to myself. Might be, I just didn't catch them. But there's the scene, peg one, fillet, Sunday morning. And I'll be back later in the year. Well, boys, I'll be keeping this glass and we'll be putting a 50p in it another time. You've got one with 50p in. Well done, boys. Great captures. Great to spend a week with all of you. Now let's make tracks to another adventure.